When you want to build any type of applications, you might come across the word API. You might ask yourself, what is an API and how it works? Before we dive into this, let me define what an API is. API stands for Applications Programming Interface. Let me explain it with a simple non-technical example. When you want to check your favorite app to see the weather forecast for today, your app will talk with other systems to get the required data. The way these systems talk to each other is with something called API. Google or Apple have not implemented temperature sensors all over the world. Instead, they use a third-party API to retrieve weather predictions. API allows different apps and services to exchange information. Nowadays, there are APIs to look up for food recipes, music lyrics, news, jokes, currency exchange, and so on. Another example would be the operating system on your phones and computers. Your operating systems provide an API to the applications that are running on it. For example, if the app wants to display a button on the screen, it just asks for the operating system to render one. The app does not have to worry about what devices it is running on, what screen resolutions, or anything like that. That brings us back to Web API. Web API is basically an API that travels through the internet. You have a client, which is a caller for the API, and you have a server, which is a respondent. This is a client-server model. The client makes a request to the server that will get routed through the internet. The server receives the request and performs whatever action that was required by the client. The server will have several endpoint setups to perform different actions. These actions could be like retrieving data from database, posting new data, or deleting existing data. Once the server performs whatever it needs on its end, it returns the response to the client. The data travels through the internet using web protocol called HTTP, which stands for Hypertext Transfer Protocol. Let me show you how to send an HTTP request. You can send an HTTP request using your standard Chrome browser. An example for this would look like the following. It starts with protocol, in this case HTTPS, so your browser knows which protocol to use. Then you need to provide hostname, in this case example.com, so your browser knows where to route your request. Then you need to provide a path, in this case you have user. So once it reaches to the server, it knows what action to perform. You can also have the optional query. For example, you can ask the server to create a new user, and the name is John. Now when you get a response from the server, there will be a status code associated with the response. This will let the client know how the request went. If everything went as expected, you will get the status code 200 range. If something went wrong, you will get status code 400 range. And status code could be in 500 range, meaning something went wrong with the server. Now let's take a look at the endpoints that are available through News API. So this API will give us all the articles about Tesla in the last month, sorted by most recent first. So the first part is the endpoint, and it gives you everything. These are parameters here, so you are querying for Tesla. Then they supply a date range. The result will be sorted by application date. Lastly, we have API key, which will identify the user. The API needs to know who is accessing the endpoint. I hope this video brought some clarities to a topic that is mostly discussed among developers. Let me know your thoughts and questions in the comment down below. Thank you so much for watching, and see you guys in the next video.